Hi, this is Naga. I work for MobilityFirst project under the guidance of Professor Dr. Ray Chaudhary. So coming to the insights of the project, the main motivation of the MobilityFirst project is the number of mobile devices in a daily basis. So in order to accommodate, as the number of mobile devices increases, IP address network is accommodated at each and every mobile node. So in order to avoid that, in order to overcome that drawback, the team has developed the mobility first architecture. So the project was mainly in two phases. The first phase was started to the and it was mainly involved in design and development architecture of this protocol stack. The second phase was started recently, and it mainly focused on the deployment of the current architecture into the real-time networks. So some of the major challenges of the MobilityFirst project are multi-homing, which involves single mobile device connecting more than two or more networks and hosting network mobility. Some of the use cases of emergency mobility first are emergency responses, vehicular networking, virtual networks, content delivery. Some of the key features of the mobility first architecture are it uses GUID as a for each and every device. So, the device, given NCS, which is the GUID can be used for identifying each and every device independently globally. So, by using this GUID, it is easier to separate the name and address into some of a particular device into two different entities. So a device can be, with the help of GUID, a device can be identified with the name and network address. So the routers of the mobility first architecture involves storage aware routing and ad hoc routing. Message transmission in the mobility first architecture is connectionless hop by hop. So the components I work in mobility first architecture during this internship program are mobility first router, which can be configured in software, the GNRS server, which is built in Java. So the Click software is a programming language which consists of elements. The elements can be written in C++ and consists of C++ header files and C++ program files. The elements can be used to configure each and every node in the Click program. So the key features of mobility first router are it follows the generalized storage aware routing, and it has a GUID-based routing and network-based routing, so it is a hybrid routing. It has a hybrid routing structure. So the GNRS server, which is also known as Global Name Resolution Service, is built in Java, and it directly maps each and every GUID with a particular set of network addresses. This is done by the distributed approach based on hashing techniques. The GNRS servers. My role in the project is mainly to develop a communication link between the mobility first router configured in Click software and the GNRS server developed in the Java. So, as a part of the internship program, I tried to create a few Click elements in C++ and try to configure the router according to them. I tried to develop a UDP socket program in C, C++, and Java so that can use this course to the components accordingly. I was successful in building socket programming communication between the client and the server in the Java. For this, I have created a click program. It does not involve the click router, MobilityFirst click router, but it I have developed a click program which can use a socket program by itself, and have built a basic Java server which runs on a local host, so which on receiving the GUID can process the data. So this is a sample click program which have used for testing the communication with the click program and the Java. So that will be creating this particular GUID every second with a limit of 3 times. So as soon as the GUID is created, the time source will be sent to the UDP socket, which will which is connected to the local host running at the the client through here. This parameter indicates that this socket is so it can send a message to the server and it can receive the acknowledgement from the server. As soon as it receives a message from the server, the data is saved in the queue and it can be later in and using the by using the contents as key. So the contents as key indicates here that the values to be printed will be in the ASCII values of the value or data. So these are the this is the result about during the socket programming and adding hashing code to the basic Java server running at the local at the port 5000. So when I try to run this program in combination with the Java server I built, the Java server first will receive the GUID, which later converts it into bytes, and then it will try to make some hashing techniques. It will try to run some hashing codes and try to produce some data, which in general for this mobility first architecture will be a set of network addresses. So right now I'm not using a valid GUID, so I'm getting some random value, which can be a negative value. But in the project, when we use proper GUIDs, we'll be getting a particular set of network addresses to which the GUID is mapped or connected or in prior. So as for the future work, I'm trying to get a clear understanding of each and every method present in the GNRS server. The GNRS server has hundreds of methods, be smaller or bigger. So understanding the GNRS server within limited time is a big task. So I'm trying to get clear understanding of each and every method present in the GNRS server. Once I get a clear understanding of each and every method, we can indicate the socket programming which I have created in the Java program with the GNRS server by calling the particular functions which can process its GUID directly from the socket program. Once everything is done, I want to check the end-to-end communication with the MobilityFirst architecture, in the sense that when the router receives a GUID, it will be transmitting the GUID to the GNRS server using socket programming. The socket program which I have built should call the related functions and hashing techniques, which will be creating some network addresses. These network addresses will be in turn be sent back to the router, so that the router can use the network addresses to forward the messages further. Thank you.